According to officials from the Presidential Advisory Committee on Exports and Industrial Development, the concluded trade mission, which was led by President Museveni in the United States of America, defined Uganda's new approach to grow export revenue. Moses Sabiti, the vice chairperson of the committee, explained that during this tour, a number of American investors expressed interest to invest in the export credit finance facility to grow Uganda's exports. Sabiti is optimistic that by June next year, this facility will be in place with funds worth $10 million, and exporters will be able to get affordable loans with less interest.
Pack houses, you need finance to be able to transport your product to the destination. So we think it will help people to grow the exports.
The facility will also facilitate production and provide funding to power the entrepreneurial ecosystem through fostering growth and standardization of products for export. Odrek Lwabogo, the chairman of the committee, said that next year, much focus will be put on developing the capacity of trade representatives in foreign countries, putting processing zones in the country, and also put in place a structured system to access markets.
There are just too many players that often you don't have, this is the microphone, okay? And for me, I've been looking for that. Can I hold on to this and see that all these are feeding? Maybe I'm too fast. Because for me, if I can't get a thing done in time, I just want to move on. So if once we digitize, perhaps we can tell which sectors are doing well and why.
The government is also expected to sign several concession agreements with new investors next year, seeking to build lodging facilities in 5 national parks, including Murchison Falls, Queen Elizabeth, and Kidepo. The investments will improve the country's tourism image on the continent and beyond.
The Ministry of Agriculture has actually already approved, and Cabinet has approved, a zoning policy. And now the next step is to fix some of these structural problems and then actually implement the zoning policy. So the policy has been done, it's been approved by Cabinet, and now the next step is, before we start to get into the zoning, we've got to look at the infrastructural issues, we've got to look at the structural problem issues, and we've got to look at the awareness issues. So it's a step-by-step process.
Report by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.